Hey guys, welcome to this video on the radius, diameter, and circumference of a circle. Circles have been around as long as the Earth has been around. People were able to see natural circles by observing the moon, the sun, and other variously natural circular shapes. The first technological invention using a circular shape, however, wasn't until 3500 BC, and it was the invention of the potter's wheel. Then, 300 years later, they were used for wheels of chariots. As people began to see the value and the use for circular shaped objects, they began to study circles. Things like radius, diameter, and circumference are terms that help us to keep track of various measurements of a circle. So now, let's take a look at what each of these measurements represent. First, let's define midpoint so you'll understand what I'm talking about as I reference it. So I'm going to draw a circle. The midpoint is the exact center of the circle, so somewhere in here. Now, let's look at these other terms. Radius is the length from the midpoint of the circle to the outer edge of the circle. The radius is represented by the lowercase letter r. Diameter is the full length of the circle, running from the edge through the midpoint all the way to the other side. That is this whole length right here. The diameter of a circle is represented by the letter D. Now, circumference is the distance around the outside edge of this circle. Circumference is represented by the uppercase letter C. Circumference is comparable to the perimeter of a shape, like a parallelogram. If you were to cut the line of this circle out and then lay it out as if it were a string, the length of that would be equivalent to its circumference. However, since a circle has a continuous curve, we use the word circumference rather than perimeter to distinguish it. Now that we've looked at what radius, diameter, and circumference are, let's look at how to calculate each one. If someone were to just kind of hand you a piece of paper with a circle on it, well, actually that'd be pretty weird. But let's say we wanted to find the radius, diameter, and circumference of that circle, and all we have is a ruler. The easiest thing to start with would be to take the ruler and measure from the very center of the circle the length between the outer edge. That would be the diameter. Let's say that when we measure, we got a length of 9 centimeters for the diameter. Well, we know that if our radius runs from the midpoint to the outer edge, then all we have to do to find the length of our radius would be to divide the length of the diameter by 2. So when we take 9 divided by 2, we get a radius length of... The formula for the radius can be written as r equals d divided by 2. And the formula for diameter can be written as d equals 2 times the radius. Now, to find the circumference of a circle, we need to use a formula. The formula for the circumference of a circle is, or it can be written as, either one works. Now, you may be asking, well, where did pi come from, and why do we all of a sudden get the circumference if we multiply said pi by our diameter? Who decided that? If you're not asking that question, you should. And I'm gonna answer it anyways. Pi is a symbol we use in mathematics to represent the number 3.14. And actually, that is just pi rounded to the nearest hundredth. Pi actually has no end and no predictable pattern. It just keeps going. However, when you see the symbol pi, generally, and in our case, 3.14 will suffice. Pi is not a random number that mathematicians made up and declared, we will multiply the diameter by the number every time and call it a circumference. On the contrary, pi was discovered to be the constant ratio between the circumference and the diameter. That is why and how we get the formula for the circumference of a circle. Now, let's take the circle with the diameter of 9 centimeters and radius of 4.5 centimeters and calculate the circumference. I'm going to use the formula with the diameter for this one. So, circumference equals, I'm going to just rewrite the formula to help us follow our work, equals pi times diameter. So now all we need to do is we need to plug in our number for diameter. This is equal to, and we said pi was equal to 3.14 times 9 centimeters. And here's our answer. Now, to practice, try drawing a circle on a piece of paper and measure your diameter with a ruler. Then find your radius in circumference. I hope that this video has been helpful for you. For further help, be sure to subscribe to our channel by clicking below. See you guys next time.